Dear students, I am your English teacher, and today we are going to start the 7th chapter. Yesterday I taught you the address. After my first visit in band, the first visit was band, there were not a solution for that meeting, and I decided to try a second time. Now I'm thinking that I should go again. Now a girl of about 15 opened the door to me. I asked her if her mother was at home. Now I just knocked at the door, and suddenly a 15-year-old girl came, and I just asked to her, "Your mother is at home?" She said, "No, she is outside." "No," she said, "my mother is doing an errand." "No, mother," I said, "I will wait for her." So I said, "I will wait for your mother." I followed the girl along the passage. An old-fashioned iron Hanukkah candle holder hung next to a mirror. We never used it because it was much more cumbersome than a single candlestick. "Would not you sit down?" she asked me. "Would not you sit down?" asked the girl. She had opened the door of the living room, and I went inside past her. I stopped horrified. I was in room I knew and did not know. I found myself in the midst of things I did not want to see again, but which oppressed me in the strange atmosphere. I was thinking, this atmosphere is strange, or because of the tasteless way everything was arranged, because of the ugly furniture or the muggy smell that hung there. The smell was coming from over there. I don't know. But I scarcely dared to look around me. The girl moved a chair. I sat down and stared at the woolen tablecloth. I rubbed it. My finger grew warm from rubbing. I followed the lines of the pattern. Somewhere on the edge there should be a burn mark that had never been repaired. "My mother will be back soon." Now the girl said to me, "My mother will come back soon. You just stay there," said the girl. "I have already made tea for her." She made a cup of tea for me. "Will you have a cup?" "Thank you." I looked up. The girl put cups ready on the tea table. She had a broad back just like her mother. She poured tea from a white board. All it had was just a gold border on the lid. I remember she opened a box and took some spoons out. "That's a nice box." I heard my own voice. The inner voice comes, and just I said, "It is a nice box." It was a strange voice, as though each sound was different in this room. "Oh, you know about them?" Now the girl asked me. "You know about them?" She had turned around and brought me my tea. "She loved my mother, says it's antique. We have got lots more." Now she informed me that she is having more antique things. She pointed round the room. See for yourself." I had no need to follow her hand. I knew which things she mean. I just looked at the still life over the tea table. As a child, I had always fancied the apple on the pewter plate. We use it for everything. Now I just missing that plate. Earlier we were using over there. She said, "Once we even had of the plates hanging there on the wall." I wanted to so much, but it was not anything special. I had found a burn mark on the tablecloth. The girl looked questioningly at me. "Yes," I said. "So used to touching all these lovely things in the house. You hardly look at them anymore. You only notice when something is missing, because it has to be repaired or because you have learned it, for example." Okay, my dear, we shall continue this story tomorrow. Till then, bye bye. Have an amazing day.